So when we're studying subtypes of problem in pathological gamblers, what we essentially want to know is, how do we treat these folks? You know, we can talk about different subtypes, like behaviorally conditioned gamblers who have a tendency to get involved in gambling through sort of the contingencies of the gambling itself, emotionally vulnerable gamblers who tend to gamble to alleviate feelings like depression or anxiety, and antisocial impulsive gamblers who have a tendency to gamble because they have impulse control problems, because it's difficult to stop, but also they have histories of conduct disorder and antisocial personality disorder, and they're quite impulsive. We want to know, when we try and subtype these folks, how can we help them? With behaviorally conditioned gamblers, for example, we might be inclined to do fairly straightforward types of cognitive behavioral approaches that helps them to realize that they may have some cognitive distortions around their gambling, that early wins are not likely to happen again, and the types of treatment that we give to them may not be quite as long or quite as involved as we might give to emotionally vulnerable gamblers, for example. So like an emotionally vulnerable gambler, on the other hand, we would probably want to address things like their anxiety, their depression, and other aspects, maybe even history of trauma or other things that sort of contribute to their need to use gambling as a way to almost self-medicate. And on the other hand, And with the third group, the antisocial impulsive gamblers, were really interested in, do we have any strategies to help them to make better decisions, to make decisions that are somewhat less impulsive, to also deal with the psychiatric comorbidity and substance use and other things that tend to go along with more of an antisocial impulsive type of perspective. For treatment providers, it's important to assess problem pathological gamblers in a way that where you can get at some of these particular traits. So I often recommend that when a gambler first comes into treatment, you give them some good measures of impulsivity, you assess whether they may have had childhood conduct disorder, adult antisocial personality disorder. Those sorts of measures will help you to get at whether they might be an antisocial impulsive gambler. Other measures might be a history of illegal activity or arrest related to their gambling. With emotionally vulnerable gamblers, I think it's extremely important that you also assess the anxiety disorders, you assess for history of trauma and post-traumatic stress disorder, and that you assess for depression, for example. Once you know, for example, if a gambler is particularly impulsive, maybe has a history of arrests, maybe has childhood conduct disorder, you might approach their treatment a little bit differently than someone who is not so impulsive but quite depressed over their gambling. And I think that it's important to come up with a sort of a good solid packet that sort of gets at these different subtypes.